Okay, so let's check out still. He was going to run for office this year. Changed his mind after a scandal came out. Still, he hopes that and then you don't want to repeat the word scandal, right? You want to, like, think of a creative way to, like, repeat it without repeating it. So he still hopes that blank will blow over eventually. And he can run again in the next election. Right, so the word still here to open up a sentence is the best place to put it. It's not like however, where you can just put it wherever you want. As a matter of fact, if we change this, so let's just fix this. So let's you could call it the ordeal, or you could call it the imbroglio. So imbroglio is like it's a confused, complicated, or embarrassing situation. So if it's a scandal, then that's sort of a synonym. You could also say, you could choose some other words here as well. But I think that's a decent word. So let's select this. And then let's change this to he still hopes. Does it fit? Well, not really. He was going to run for office this year, but changed his mind after the scandal came out. Period. He still hopes that the imbroglio would blow over eventually, will blow over eventually, and he can run again in the next election. He still hopes. So here, I would actually delete the word still. I wouldn't even use the word still. So, and it's not like you can do comma, still, comma, like you can do with however, for example. You know, he hopes that comma, however, comma, blah, 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 the imbroglio. But still, so still generally is going to be at the beginning of a sentence. If you use it in this way, if it's a connective way to connect ideas. Still, he hopes the imbroglio will blow eventually, and he can run again in the next election. It's sort of like nevertheless. It's pretty synonymous with nevertheless. It's similar. Because nevertheless, if you really, really wanted to, you could put it in between, inside the sentence. Let's use the other, but also is used as, in another way. Now, obviously, still is used in myriad ways, but these are the two main ways. So the most common and very common way in the middle of a sentence. So let's check it out. So this is going to be somewhat similar. So let me show you structurally what I think would be ideal. He still hopes that he will be able to run again in the next election. But I wouldn't say the next election. I would say, so this is sort of like in general. Right, so, you know, still could be used as sort of general. Most common way to use it, right? It's the most common way to use the word still. He's going to run for office this year, but changed his mind after the scandal came out. He still hopes that he'll be able to run. He still hopes that he will be able. So if something just happened, then the hope is brand new. So for him to still hope, it's a little bit redundant, or it's a little bit, overkill. I think this is better. So you could say something like, so what has he been doing? So does something, right? And then still does the same thing, right? Does or thinks something, and then still does or thinks the same thing. So in terms of time, you want to kind of keep that in mind. He was going to reference this here, but changed his mind after this sound came out. He still believes in his future. Believes in, positive future prospects. He still believes in positive future prospects, but knows that it will take some time for the general public to forgive his transgressions. And this is just a sentence. This isn't any indictment on, men in politics. I mean, I think that, probably a lot of this stuff is like, sort of as an aside, a lot of this stuff is like any other thing, right? It's the bell curve, right? So you're going to have people that are very untoward in any job, any industry, right? Any place. And obviously that might skew a little bit different, depending on, the industry, but that's just kind of an aside. But this isn't like a gendered thing. This isn't like an anti-political thing. This is just a fun, not really fun, but it's a full sentence, a full sentence, or full block of sentences. I like all three of these. I like all three of these. He was going to run for office this year, but changed his mind after the scandal came out. So did the scandal come out after this? Yeah, it came out. So like the scandal, the story, the scandal came out. You could say the story of the scandal came out. The scandal story came out. Well, actually, it came out. It sort of came out into the public view. So it kind of fits. It fits in with how we see it written in general. And this type of story, we've seen this phrasing. So that's the other thing, too, is you want to keep in mind the common phrasing. I'm not a big fan of, like, super, super sort of colloquial, like, communication, especially in general journalism. But this isn't really colloquial. This isn't really, like, pedestrian writing. It's not like, you know, using expletives or, you know, it's just a common phrase that you normally would see after the scandal came out or after the scandal broke. So that's a very common, phrasing. Okay, so he still believes in positive future prospects. And his, right, it's a little bit clearer. You want to be as clear as possible, right? But make the reader work a little bit. He was going to run for office this year, but changed his mind after the scandal broke. He still believes in his positive future prospects, but knows that it will take some time for the general public to forgive his transgressions. Okay, so this kind of makes sense. So he does or thinks, so let's just say he does or thinks something might not be explicit, right? It might not be explicitly described. So obviously he believes in his positive future prospects if he's running for office. It's very expensive. It's a lot of stress, especially if he has a family. It's a lot of scrutiny, etc. Right. So we can assume, and here's where we're gonna push the reader again, is we're gonna assume that he believes in his positive future prospects when he was thinking about running for office this year. Right. So the fact that he says he still believes in his future positive future prospects, now that makes sense. Because that, you know, presumption is probably correct. Obviously, you're not going to run for office if you don't think you're going to win. I mean, I guess there are other reasonings why people do things. But based on just these two sentences, you know, the information that we have in front of us, that's generally what the obvious guess is going to be as far as the motivation. So he still believes in his positive future prospects. But you can't say he still hopes that the Imbruglia will blow over eventually, because that doesn't make sense. Because if he still does something, that means he was doing it before. Well, this moment of the scandal breaking. So let's just say, right, you have a moment of scandal breaking. Right, so let's say he is going to run for office. Right, this is like a time frame thing, and then there's the moment of the scandal breaking. Right, and then after that, so he still does or thinks something. Well, so how can he still do it if it just started here? Right? So if the moment of scandal breaking is here, then that's the moment. So this is the moment when he hopes it will blow over soon. Right, so the moment it happens, he's thinking, man, I hope it blows over soon or eventually or whatever. So for him to still think or do something, it has to continue. So it has to continue all the way across here. So as far as time, this is really important. As far as time, he has to... He has to think or do something that lasts this entire time, right? Because this is sort of the context of these two sentences, right? This sort of time frame, this block, this like event, this moment, and then afterwards, like what we're talking about, his current thoughts. So we can't say this, because he wasn't hoping that the Imbruglia would blow over here. He wasn't hoping, because the imbroglio didn't happen yet. The scandal broke here, right? The general public found out about here. So, you know, we can only say, well, he still believes in his positive future prospects, right? So he's going to run for office. he believes in, you know, his positive future prospects. Right, he obviously does. Otherwise, he's not going to, like, run for office. And so, what's cool about this, and this happens a lot, I think this is, like, decent writing, is that, again, this fits our thesis of be very clear, but make the reader work a little bit. And so this is a classic example. You know, he, you know, like, you're not going to say believing, you know, believing deeply in his future. He was going to run for office this year, but changed his mind after the scandal broke. He still believes in his future, positive future prospects, but knows that it will take some time. This is so repetitive. This is so repetitive. So what you want to do is you want to omit this and then sort of surprise the reader here. You kind of want to surprise the reader right here. So, you know, and there's a bit of surprise or reveal element with, you know, quality writing. You know, don't be repetitive. And that's what this would be. This would be repetitive if you added this on in the front there. So hopefully this is helpful. And these are three good two-sentence blocks that totally make sense. These are different uses of the word still, though. So just kind of keep that in mind. And then here in this second sentence, we're not using still. It's actually redundant here. He still hopes that the burglar, he doesn't, or it's not redundant. It's actually grammatically incorrect. So hopefully this is helpful. Thank you very much.